Superyachts takes you behind the scenes of superyacht construction, a world where precision is essential and design is king. These vessels won't just get from A to B, they're works of maritime art. Each detail is meticulously planned, and every inch of every yacht is built by craftsmen. But it all starts with a simple sketch.
Dat toilet staat natuurlijk heftig in de weg.
Is wel mooi, maar...
Een beetje te snel getekend, denk ik. Dus hier moet je nog even wat voor bedenken.
This is Superyachts. True superyacht needs a great design. This Dutch architecture firm in Sneek designs, styles and engineers multi-million dollar superyachts. Currently, the team are working worldwide on approximately 20 new boats, including 7 superyachts. But the entire process, from a dream to a genuine superyacht, is a journey that can take up to 52 months.
What's so fun about it? What's not fun about it? I mean, we get the opportunity to play with water all day.
And to work in a team to create the dream for our clients.
Yeah.
Martin Lunting is a man with an unconventional dream. Having retired as CEO of his insurance company, he now lives in mundane Monaco. He already owns several yachts, and his dream is to design one himself. But Martin's vision is distinctly radical.
It's very, very difficult to talk to the industry, asking them to think out of the box. And I've said, let me take the difficult route by starting with my own design and ending with the shipyard.
The new ship has to be 35 meters long, 8.5 meters wide, and will have some remarkable features. Martin wants the engine room to be divided in two, with a hallway between the sections and glass walls so visitors can take a look inside. He wants to have no stairs on the outside. Two folding hatches are to be built in the hull for the tender and the swimming platform. The rear of the ship has to be a canoe stern, which is shaped like a bow. Martin's friend Rob de Lange helps him sketch out his eccentric ideas.
Het zou natuurlijk heel gaaf zijn als dat je entree zou zijn op het zondek.
Als dit de schoorsteen is die rond is, als we de trappen gaat naar beneden trap laten komen, dan heeft die schoorsteen die krijgt ook functie.
I would like to avoid visible staircases as much as possible.
So now, if you do this, we have a functional design.
Yeah, the only problem is that is it technically possible?
Yeah.
Because when you build a yacht, you are subject to classification and shipping inspection, and they will look in terms of safety.
Martin has called in professional superyacht designers Marnix and Bart to help him with his ideas, and they've traveled to Monaco to meet him.
Welkom aan boord, zou ik zeggen. Is goed uit, hè? Hey Bart. Hi, hi. How is Steve?
This owner is as typical owner as he's atypical, as is with every owner. People come to us to actually buy a little dream, buy a little happiness. And every owner is different in that respect, and therefore also the same.
Ja, wij zijn eruit.
Fantastisch.
Kunnen jullie lekker rondgevaren?
Ja, cool.
We hebben nog een hele grote uitdaging vandaag. He, dus Martin zijn idee was dat we dus hier ergens een luik maken die dus naar buiten toe open kan in het water, dat het meteen een soort zwemplateau is.
Dus letterlijk een garage inbouwen?
Ja, ja, ja.
Waar je...
Ja. Ja.
Want we gaan inderdaad voor een spitsgat.
Canoestern is een must en een waaiersteven is een must.
Ja, en dan hebben we hier ook wel een klep.
Als jullie daar een klep goedgekeurd kunnen krijgen, zou het heel
fijn zijn. Ja, dat zou heel super zijn. Ja.
Trouwens, ik weet niet of je dit makkelijk goedgekeurd krijgt.
The harbor in Monaco is full of prestigious yachts, so they sail around to check out some of the vessels that have influenced Martin's design.
Daar komt de inspiratie vandaan. Het
komt heel langzaam naar je toe.
Jeetje, vergeet hè. Zo mooi die zee weer terugkomt, hè.
geweldig, hè?
Ja.
Is die nog van Abramovic?
Nou, ik weet niet of hij hem op een gegeven moment verkocht heeft of niet. Dat wil ik vanaf zijn.
Nou, maar dat is wel het bijzondere. Als we dus, als we die garage, als we die ontworpen krijgen op een 35 meter jacht, ja. Dat is het enige.
In the Netherlands, all of Martin's complex wishes are explained to the 5-strong design team. Everything has to be discussed and weighed up, especially since several demands are unique and have not been attempted before.
De wensen van de klant zijn is om de eigenaarshut bovenin kwijt te kunnen. Natuurlijk verliezen we daardoor de sky lounge, maar als je hier het bed hebt en je kijkt naar buiten, dat is natuurlijk fantastisch.
En de trap hier achterop, blijft die of?
Blijft die? Nou, het is wel een wens van de klant om deze trap weg te halen.
So one of the most challenging parts is to explain to the team back in the office here the things the owner told us when we had the meeting back in Monaco.
The project's head of design is Robin. He has to incorporate every single specification into one blueprint, first on paper, then in 3D, and finally in the actual construction.
En wat we ook kunnen doen is hier zo glazen ribbels in maken. Dat je het licht van boven erin hebt schijnen.
Ja, oké. Als je dit in dat van glas maakt, dan krijg je in de trap gaat naar beneden, krijg je tot beneden helemaal licht. Dat is wel mooi. We moeten ze op de constructie wel even weten, dat we gaan doen.
Dan kunnen we ook even gelijk kijken naar de tender area.
Ja.
Hier misschien zie je het beste. Kijk, als deze zo openklapt, kun je die tender pakken en die kan er zo uitschuiven. Dan rust die op de klep. En dan kun je de klep gebruiken om die tender goed naar buiten te krijgen.
Licht laten glijden, ja. Dan kun je meteen zien dat die ronding hier aan de binnenzijde niet doorgezet moet worden van de buitenzijde.
Nee,
dat
inderdaad.
Is bij het model ook niet goed gegaan.
Ja.
Dus als we dat uitzetten, moet deze vlak blijven.
En als je die jetskis dan op een slide maakt, dat hij hem oppakt en die opzet en dan naar buiten glijdt.
Hetzelfde kredel. Ja. Ja. Ja, goed plan.
The first designs may be complete, but is it technically possible to turn them into reality? And even if it is, the superyacht has to be safe and stable before it gets clearance to be built.
This is the compartment, so from here to all the way up to here. This is the
all the way up to the collision box.
We calculate for stability, we calculate for load lines and other safety issues, like fire control plans and safety plans. And we also configure the tank arrangement and the propulsion arrangement. So basically everything below the waterline, that's what we take care of.
The design process is the most important phase of building a superyacht.
It is very important to deliver Mr. Lanting a safe yacht, also in terms of stability. Therefore, we check both intact as well as damaged stability. And currently, we're checking the survivability of the motor yacht as a result of one compartment damage. Maybe another option is to reduce the amount of water which will actually enter the compartment.
The influence of the liquids on the stability is very significant. When we have fuel and fresh water in the tanks, which can be very large amounts, and they go from side to side when the vessel sways, it has a very adverse effect on the stability of the boat.
Coming up, the design is judged by the Classification Society. Without their approval, the ship can't be built.
We are paid to be a pain in the ass, that's correct.
And Bart and Marnix travel to Nice to get a grip on Martin's wishes for the interior.
Dat, sorry, dit hoort in een Bentley thuis, niet op een boot.
Designers Marnix Hoekstra and Bart Bauhaus and their team are working on the Rosso Mare, a 35-meter yacht for demanding client Martin Lanting. 4 months on, the team is ready to show the first sketches, which include Martin's unconventional ideas.
Als we die garage, als we die ontworpen krijgen op een 35-meter yacht, dat is het enige. I would like to avoid visible staircases as much as possible.
Canoe stern is a must. En een waaiersteven is een must.
Ja.
Did they accurately interpret his unconventional wishes? Are they correct, down to the tiniest detail? If not, the whole project could fall through.
Goedemorgen. Lennox.
Hey. Hi, goedemorgen.
Welkom in Sneek.
Dank je.
We gaan naar boven.
Hey, Carl. Welkom.
Alles wel?
Jongen. Zo, Lennox.
Martin, welkom. Welkom.
Well, you have to take really, really good care of these clients, and not in a way that you have to serve them, but you have to try to adapt to their needs. Realize that buying a mega yacht is the most expensive, most difficult part product you can buy for yourself. It's more expensive than owning a 747 Boeing in that respect.
Het enige wat we nu hier wel zien is dat hier natuurlijk die trappenkolom ziet. Ja. En het zou natuurlijk wel prettig zijn als daar een beetje doorzicht
dat je door kan blijven kijken.
Ja, inderdaad. Dus dat toilet wat hier staat, dat staat natuurlijk heftig in de weg.
Ja, op zich, deze locatie is wel mooi.
Hebben jullie een beetje te snel getekend, denk ik.
Ja.
Dus hier moet je nog even wat voor bedenken.
Creating someone's dream is not an easy task. It takes vigorous debates about possibilities and impossibilities and the gray area in between.
I found it very disturbing in the symmetry of the design that you have staircases outside. So I wanted a design which would make it possible to have the staircases inside and to leave the staircases outside away completely.
We definitely have to discuss this with the International Classification Society of the yacht. And they set rules for safe operation of the yacht at sea, escape routes as well, not only just practical routing. And yeah, this is new, and we'll have a firm discussion with them, I'm sure.
There has been a lot of kind of tension where they felt like our experience is to do it like this. And every time I came in and said, I still think we should do it in another way.
Seeing possibilities for a groundbreaking design isn't enough. The team can't continue without the approval of the RINA, the Royal Institution of Naval Architects. And some parts of the design have never been seen before.
Hey. We approve the design, that's the plan approval part. But when the plan and the drawings are approved, when everything is okay, we also review the actually building of the ship.
That the unions are sort of removable.
It's extra cost, but you can regard it as a quality assurance. So if you buy a ship with certificates, it fulfills the requirements that if you follow the rules, you can be quite sure that you have a safe ship.
The biggest issues are the hatches for the beach club and the tender garage. When they're open, water can come in. So they need extra safety measures to prevent the water from flooding the entire vessel.
In het ergste geval stroomt er ook nog water in dit deel. En eigenlijk daar hebben we het dan over. En we zeggen nu, als je hier dat schot zet, dan is dit deel van die tender bay, daar mag dan water in komen, zeggen we dan. Het is eigenlijk waar we het nu alleen nog over hebben, dat is dit deel.
Als je kijkt, denk ik, naar wat er gebeurt als er water in komt. Het nadeel van die hele boxconstructie is ook dat je asymmetrische flooding gaat krijgen. Ja, waardoor we natuurlijk slag zou kunnen verwachten op het moment dat het volloopt. En op het moment dat het één ruimte is over de hele breedte.
We are paid to be a pain in the ass. Sometimes it's difficult. Sometimes you have in the design, you have a problem. Which cannot be solved according to the rules. And then we have a conflict.
Alleen met technisch kijken, dan kijken we naar het algemeen plan. En dan komt die. Zou die dus zo in moeten komen om ruimte om de deuren te houden?
They for sure have to go back to the drawing boards and you have touched upon solutions today, but still they have to work it out. It's their issue, it's their design, and we have to see where they come up with, and that's our role to review it again. Basically, that's the story.
Marnix and Bart invite Martin to Nice to take a look at a 46.5-meter motor yacht. Before they start to design the interior of his new ship, they want Martin to see the real thing. This should help him to get some ideas of what he wants for his own yacht to be.
Welcome on board.
Ah, leuk.
Listening is one of the most important parts. They have so much in their minds which they want to express, and they accept that our team has to draw it, but they have to explain it to us.
Je moet de pilaren een heel eventje, klein beetje wegdenken en je denkt alles in het wit. Dan heb je al heel klein beetje de sfeer, zoals wij die proefden van de Rosemare.
It's always nice to see something on a drawing But it's even nicer if you can get really close to the real world.
Deze is ook allemaal vastgezet. Ja. Dus die zijn allemaal safe vast. Zodat daar niks van omvalt. Dan hebben we de brug. We zijn op een iets grotere jacht uiteraard.
Dit hoort in een Bentley thuis, niet op een boot. Dat wat nou?
Maar wel mooi uitgevoerd, zie je dat? Ja, mooi boek leeggelegd. Ja. Anders strak eigenlijk.
Ja, je hebt zeker geen Bentley.
Nee,
dit moet je proberen. Dit moet je nautisch houden.
Iets rustiger voor de
scheeps. Scheeps.
Most of our owners, they think very carefully of everything they want to do over a long term.
Dit vind ik wel heel erg mooi.
Ja, ik ook.
Ik vind niet zo'n knuppeltje, niet zo'n dingetje. Gewoon heerlijk, een ouderwets
stuurwiel. Yeah. If he sees something here, which we explained and attracts him, he will again think quite carefully on whether this will change his mind or not. If that would happen, like on the spot here, I would be surprised, but I think all in all it was a good visit in any case.
The Department of Hydraulic Engineering at the Technical University in Delft has a special laboratory to perform tests on ship models. Their facilities include a basin containing 1.5 million liters of water. The water is dyed green so it's clearly visible against the models. Today, the design of the ship is going to be thoroughly analyzed.
It's an exact copy of the hull design. You can imagine when you would have it full scale, it would not fit inside the building. It's a bit unpractical. So for practical reasons, we're scaling it down and allowing us to do measurements which are actually as valid as full scale measurements. These tests are very, very important. Eh? Of course, the client really wants to be certain that the speed that he has in mind for this vessel are actually attained. So we really need to know how much power exactly will be required in order to sail the speed of 13.5 knots.
The testing starts in calm water. The waves in the water can be varied, ranging from normal waves to irregular waves, simulating any weather condition. Important issues like the maximum speed and the dynamic trim, which is the backwards inclination or heel the yacht makes when it accelerates, are measured.
We test at various speeds, from low speeds of 8 knots up to 13.5 knots, and at all speeds we closely watch the behavior of the boat, particularly the trim, the dynamic trim. When the vessel gets up to speed, and we will see that it has a tendency to trim down on the stern, and we have to closely watch if it's not too much, because that can negatively affect the resistance of the vessel. We have to assume that our clients, they will go anywhere in the world to all the places which might be of their interest. We do tests, and normally we focus on some worst case scenarios so that we know that the vessel is safe then, and then we can safely assume that in worldwide operation the vessel will be okay. The accelerations that we measured in the waves, they are well within the acceptable range, so that's looking very good. The additional resistance due to the waves is there, but it's very acceptable. And the only thing is that we've seen some things on the wave pattern and on the green water at the bow, which might require some adjustments. So maybe we will have to go back to the drawing board, adjust the bow a little bit, give it some more flair, and then I think for the rest, we're quite happy.
7 months into the project, the designers are ready to show Martin the first samples and interior designs. He's not the easiest man to please, so every detail has to be absolutely right.
There are thousands of details for the interior and in the exterior of a yacht. You need to have a lot of presentations, personal presentations with the owner, to be able to share all these details. It's his personal, private object to make sure it's all perfect.
Handwerk.
Ik denk dat we deze deur er misschien uit moeten halen. Daar hebben we ook een ander voorstel voor gemaakt.
Mm-hmm. Each client is different. Basically, we like the more difficult clients, because the difficult clients are pushing you to a new challenge, to the next level of detailing, the next level of complexity. They go to every detail.
Nou, dan beginnen we met de basiskleur voor het schilderwerk. Ja. Daar hadden we destijds deze kleur voor uitgekozen.
Voor op de vloer een eikenhouten vloer in visgraat gelegd. Dus alle jaren 30.
Selecting the luxurious fabrics, timber, marble and leather can be a bit of a minefield.
En dan willen we het 3D-model aan u presenteren.
Ja.
Dit is het uiteindelijke resultaat.
Je ziet hier heel goed het effect van de lichte panelen. Met de schaduw, met de schaduwwerking, met de rust die daarvan uitgaat.
3D presentations are very important, especially for the interior, where it is what you see is what you get. The little bit challenging part there is that the client is judging everything. So when you have blue pillows and the client doesn't like blue, he's disapproving the whole image, while basically it's only due to the pillows.
The bar?
Ja.
En daar zie je ook het Art Deco glas en lood detail wat we daarin in verwerkt hebben om dat specifieke gevoel een heel klein beetje toch even op te roepen.
Even een paar dingen. Ik zou graag de bar terug willen zien. Ik denk dat je een stoel zoals hier nu ontworpen en neergezet, ik denk niet dat het kan. Als ik het heb over een knipoog naar Art Deco, dan denk ik niet dat een barkruk zoals deze past in het interieur. Dus ik zou jullie willen vragen hier nog eens heel goed naar te kijken. En dan I'm really surprised on the outcome because it was necessary to close the gap between leaving your home and coming on board. And I think we have achieved it.
Coming up, materials for the ship's interior are selected. And the team travels to Italy in search of lighting worthy of a superyacht.
For the price it cost, you could pick out a nice sports car.
Uncompromising Martin Lunting has commissioned yacht designers Marnix and Bart and their team to help him realize his radical vision for a 35-meter superyacht. Now that they have the client's approval on the interior design, they have to choose the bespoke engineering parts. Martin wants to be able to steer his own superyacht, so a controllable pitch propeller is recommended, increasing maneuverability.
Mr. Lanting asked us to enable him to maneuver his 35-meter motor yacht by himself and to equip his yacht with a bow thruster, a stern thruster, and a controllable pitch propulsion system.
He can move sideways, he can move forward, aft, he can also keep his position.
Yeah.
And the only thing he is controlling actually is the joystick. And the joystick, by means of this control box, is controlling all these propulsion items.
Normally, ships have a fixed propeller. The ship's course can only be altered by changing the engine's direction of rotation, and the blades of the propeller are fixed. This propeller is variable, so its blades can be adjusted while the rotation of the engine remains unchanged. This means that the speed of the ship can be changed without having to alter the engine's direction of rotation, providing the accuracy to maneuver to the millimeter.
This is how the mechanism works, and then the blades rotate.
Yeah. This will be filled with grease?
Yeah, the whole cavity will be filled with grease.
Okay.
We have here some grease points to fill it.
Yeah.
It is for insulation.
Yeah.
And after that you can, from the inside of the vessel, when she's in the water, you can continuously fill it with grease.
The simulator, the propeller shaft is tested for energy use at all different positions.
I'm performing an endurance test and I'm checking the temperature under different RPMs. And by pushing these buttons you can control the pitch, you can try it. And now inside you see this arrow moving and then you can see the pitch.
Forward. It's going
very slow. But.
And this is all electronic, so no hydraulics attached?
Everything is electronic.
That's simple.
When you're building a superyacht, the entire interior is constructed away from the shipyard before it's fitted on board. For this yacht, the construction takes place at the town of Strayen in the west of the Netherlands. Practically everything is homemade, from the walls, ceilings and door frames to all the furniture. A few materials have to be brought in, like some of the more exclusive kinds of wood required for the furniture.
As you remember, we discussed the veneer inlays on the various tabletops. Yep.
And I'm very curious to see what you can do for that.
Okay, Bart, we use the mirror technique. So when we move the mirror, you can now determine what the look will be of this table. So the starting point can be light, can be darker.
Mr. Lanting is requiring an interior which has something old, something new. Basically, what he wants is a classic interior with a modern touch.
This is when a possible decision is made in a preparation phase, and it might look like this on the table. You can feel that it's absolutely seamless, although there is a seam.
And the precision?
Well, the veneer is 0.6 millimeter thick, very thin, but the connection is seamless, and the gluing connection is even stronger than the veneer itself. So if you would try to break this, you break the wood and not the seam.
The veneer is so expensive, a change of mind during construction could prove disastrous. So the team developed a method to help the client make the ultimate choice.
Clients have modifications, that's important. It's their personal object, so we have to react rapidly, swiftly. We're trying to minimize the changes in this production stage by showing them very realistic renderings in the design, in the engineering stage. That's how we solve that.
You can see we prepared some detailing for you. Yep. As designed.
This is the profile.
According to the design, it friendly curves and...
This is a very nice friendly shape.
Yeah. There was a modification that you would like to discuss about the inside of the cabinet.
Yeah, we need to change this fiddle to make the storage of the shelves a little bit more seaworthy.
Okay.
So that's what he...
To prevent the books from falling out.
Yeah, he wants to raise this just a little bit, this with 15 mil and this with 2 centimeters.
All right. Here we have finished the first two pieces of the mock-up, the drawer cabinet and the bookcase of the owner. I'm really curious what your first opinion is about it.
The first opinion is that it's exactly as the sample. Beautiful. Also the color.
Yeah. The finishing, in my opinion, is spot on.
Very, very smooth. Yeah, I think we have to add the hardware. Yeah. The glass in. We assemble it to one room.
Correct.
And then we invite Mr. Lanting to give his final approval.
I look forward to that.
In Snake, designer Robin is still struggling with the ship's tender garage, which houses the support boat. Having a side entrance means there will be a large hole in the yacht's hull, weakening the ship along its length. The hatch needs to open more than 90 degrees, but the cylinder that controls the mechanism can't extend that far. Jim Horovitz is the lead structural draftsman on the team. He calculates the strength of the tender hatch as well as the strength of the ship's spine. He's the engineer who has to come up with solutions for impossible demands.
Probleem, en dat zit hier in die klep.
Ja.
Wij denken dat als de tender naar buiten schuift en over die klep heen gaat, mm-hmm. dat we een probleem krijgen met die cilinder. Zeker omdat die tender nog best wel wat weegt in mm-hmm. combinatie met die klep.
Ja. Ja, ik denk wel dat er mogelijkheden zijn. Kijk, want als je hem hier pakt, dit is de slag die hij moet hebben om erop te kunnen trekken.
Mm-hmm, deze.
En dit is hem die in dichte stand heeft. Als ik dan de cilinder een beetje, of die liever een klein beetje bijdraai, dan hebben we weer net dat extra stukje slag om hem open te krijgen. Mm-hmm. Dan moeten we alleen dit stukje extra slag nog zien te bereiken door een nieuw aangrijpingspunt te bedenken.
Oké. Okay.
One surprisingly important element of superyacht design is lighting. A few beautiful lamps can illuminate the already luxurious features to ultimate effect. But they don't come cheap. The average superyacht lamp might cost as much as 30,000 euros, enough to buy a small car. They're expensive because of the highly specialized techniques used to produce them.
Lights is very important. Also think about the safety aspect. Hey, if the courtesy lights are working, there's an emergency, the owner will have a lot of art in his boat. This art needs to be lit as well. The bar needs a different color and tone of the light. When you, with a tender, go to your boat, which is in for anchor in a nice bay, you want to see your boat. It has to be beautiful, lit from the outside as well.
You get strange requests now and then. Obviously, you're making a handmade product. So one of the most extreme lighting fixtures I clearly remember was nearly the size of a big container. For the price it cost, you could pick out a nice sports car.
In a specialized laboratory in Tuscany, designers work exclusively on super yacht lamps.
How many lumen does...
Living room?
Yeah?
We calculate in lux.
Oh, okay.
We calculate it in lux because lumens is the amount of light, but lux is the punctual light, so okay. The light that is here, in this mm-hmm. surface. In a room, average is 200-250 lux. And another good exercise is to test the lights in their environment. This is seawater. And this is an underwater light.
Okay.
We tested these lights for years. This lamp has been switched on 2 years ago, and it's still on. Oh. We put one of the lights here, and we switch the water. You can check whether the water has penetrated in or not. Ah.
Lamp design may be crucial. But energy sustainability and conservation are just as important. Increasingly, yachts use LED lighting, which is less wasteful.
So this is another small lab where we test all the electrical components and how they behave with the temperature emitted by LEDs. Normally, people think that LEDs are very cool, and this is quite right. But when an LED is on, it emits temperature. And this temperature can go up to 65 degrees.
It's not only with the modern technology that we use LED lighting, but we need to understand how much heat it is producing. So our people from the mechanical department also know how much generator power the air conditioning actually needs, because the light is making heat. So the depth is of the light within our engineering is really, really to the lowest level.
Wow.
Okay.
In what kind of room you're going to use this?
Well, we use it a different way. It's a ceiling, complete ceiling, or
so you don't
door,
see it.
Or, okay. or a shelf, or anything you like.
Coming up, Martin's in Tuscany, searching for a shipyard to build his super yacht.
And I do not want to buy one of your boats. Mm. I want my boat to be built by you.
Mm. Duidelijker
als dit kun je het niet brengen.
Volgens mij begrijpen ze het niet.
And superyacht designer Marnix Hoekstra are in Italy. It's more than 14 months since their first meeting, and the time has come to pick a shipyard to build the superyacht. Martin has his heart set on the build taking place in Italy.
I'm very passionate to do it in Italy because it's a country full passion, and I also think that value for money wise, I can do a good deal. Now, what I'm going to present the shipyard is to let them understand that somebody else can design a boat as well.
But the shipyard owners misunderstand Martin's request. They follow tradition and start selling an off-the-shelf yacht to Martin, unaware that he has his own bespoke design.
As you can see, this is a classical 32 meters,
okay.
rounded stern, full displacement.
Okay, fantastic.
Very strong boat.
I think Martin will quickly correct them right now, because this is exactly not what he wants. Absolutely, he wants to be invited by the shipyard and look at the boat, but typically the shipyard then takes you to a boat from the Siri instead of a custom boat like we have in the package. So it will be quite quickly they're surprised, because we want to go in the office and show them their boat instead of buying one of those.
This is all steel.
This is real. Strong boat. Very strong boat.
You know that this was my inspiration.
Yeah, I know.
Okay,
the boat.
You know,
yeah, I know your boat.
And because this is the boat that you have built.
Yeah.
Now I've gone further and further and further, and I do not want to buy one of your boats.
Mm.
I want my boat to be built by you.
Mm.
Non sei.
The Italians haven't quite grasped the idea. Normally, they are the ones who are in charge of the design and construction. In this case, the Dutch design company would oversee the build.
You don't need to make any more drawings. You just need very good skilled workers to execute the details the way Martin would like to have them.
It is a new collaboration in the shipbuilding industry for superyachts. We'll see. I know, in the meantime, that building a ship is about using a lot of suppliers and using a lot of subcontractors. Are you allow me to come with you to have a look there and say, I'm satisfied, I'm not satisfied, I want to see some...
For sure. We will do more.
The Italians seem to warm up to the idea.
This kind of preliminary deal, no? They are not looking exactly for one of the boat on our catalog. But the customer, they think that we can be the right builder for the project. This is the most important thing.
We follow your ideas and you must check our quality.
Absolutely.
It could be one of the most interesting experiences we had in our background.
I think they got the message. It's still a lot of things to be done, but they are ready to cooperate and collaborate.
Yeah, I think they were a little bit shocked, like we anticipated, so we prepared for that very well. They looked through the papers more. It's new, but that's what we wanted. It's different. I would say it's actually quite exciting because the whole team has worked so hard for this. You've worked so hard for this. And now we have a new face. We're gonna actually build this boat. It's very exciting.
The actual build of the ship will take another 2 years. In Strahan, preparations have started for the ship's furniture. It can take up to 18 months to engineer, manufacture, and install a complete yacht's interior. Building furniture for a ship is quite different from that of a house.
A yacht is a moving object. It's basically made of steel and aluminum. As it is a moving object, a yacht does something like this. For example, when you open a drawer, you don't want it to bang out of the cabinet because the ship is moving.
The company works with special kinds of veneer, but not to decrease the weight. With veneer, the craftsman can fully control the final look of the interior. Floors are cut out of the grain, leaving the ultimate pattern for a specific piece of furniture.
When we use solid wood, you never know what you find inside of the tree. But with veneer, it gives you area to play with. A lot of different veneering techniques are possible. Sliding veneering sheets, where there is a repetitive effect. Open book, where we can do the open book 2 times. We can also do it 4 times, where we have a diamond feature.
After the veneer is cut, the leaves are glued together in a special machine. Gluing the 0.6 millimeter edges together only takes 5 to 6 seconds, but it leaves a seam that's stronger than the veneer itself. Then the bigger leaves are glued together to make even larger sheets of veneer.
When those sheets are made, it is being glued and pressed on a base material, and that is mainly plywood. It can be honeycomb as well, if lightweight is applicable.
As soon as the plywood has the correct measurements, the veneer is added. Every side needs to have the same high-end look and feel. That's why a different machine takes care of the edges. From that process on, the cabinets are made.
The manufacturing process of custom interiors is very labor-intensive. There are very unique designed furniture elements that sometimes require over 240, 260 man hours only for production.
But 240 man hours come with a price tag. A cabinet like this, for instance, costs 30,000 euros, the same price as a lamp. There's just one more step to go before the construction can start. All designs and calculations have to be signed off by Martin. After 6 months of construction, a miniature model of the yacht is ready.
Today we're going to show the model to Mr. Lanting. And I'm very curious, because it's always a very exciting moment. We made this really detailed ship model for him, and hopefully he will be just as enthusiastic as we are.
A specialized team of craftsmen have worked for 6 months to construct the miniature model of the yacht.
When you want to have a very small scale model, not all details can be made. But if you have a bit of a larger scale, like 1 to 10, then I think everything is almost possible. You can make it exactly like it is on the real yacht.
First, they split the 3D image of the ship in as many parts as possible. Each part can then be copied.
Ik ben nu gewoon het sundekken aan het uitpakken. Dit gedeelte kan ik nu gewoon helemaal apart gaan frezen. Dit stuk.
The different parts are now cut out of a piece of foam by a milling machine. It takes several steps to get to the final shape of a sundeck. A rough milling cutter takes care of the outline of the sundeck. Increasingly finer cutters help shape the specific detail. Everything on the model has to look the same as the real thing, but it's made of different materials.
When we have a stainless steel railing, it does not necessarily have to be stainless steel. We can also use brass and then chrome, because on the model you cannot see if a chair has been made of real wood or just from plastic and painted. So we try to use the most efficient material for us.
The foam hull and superstructure of the model are finished with two layers of primer and one or two final layers. Significantly less than a real ship, but this one won't be in the water.
The basic model, the shape of it, we can use sophisticated machines for that. But when you make all the details, that's much harder. A lot of craftsmanship is needed to make the small chairs, the small tables, and all these kind of parts. So I think detailing, that takes most of the hours.
It can take up to 20 hours to build a simple chair. Building an entire model can take 400 to 3,000 man hours, depending on the amount and accuracy of the details.
Everyone can make a model, but not everyone can make a nice model, because that's something completely different. That makes us proud here, too, if we achieve something which someone else cannot do.
But the average model is a rather expensive toy at 16,000 euros, or in superyacht terms, half a lamp.
A model is extra cost, but when you see the impact of the model and the value, the intrinsic value of a model, it's absolutely worth the money, absolutely.
But first, Martin has to give his final verdict on the 3D animation.
Nou, ik vind het heel mooi. We hebben natuurlijk de schetsen hadden we natuurlijk al goedgekeurd, maar je ziet het hier nu bijna in het echt, hè?
Ja.
And then the moment arrives to reveal the model of the ship.
Eigenlijk moet je het zo zien.
Wow.
Okay.
Oh, yours. Waanzinnig.
After many months of hard work, the final design is ready and approved, incorporating Martin's wildest wishes. The canoe stern, the flared bow, no visible staircases on the outside, and an almost invisible side entrance to the tender garage. All they have to do now is build this super yacht.
The spaces are much, much bigger than I ever expected. I'm fanatic about Italy, and I think it will sail a lot in Italian waters, but a ship like this can easily go to the Caribbean as well. So it's not just an Italian dream, it will probably also be a global dream.